Any educational institution is best judged by its graduates. At the H. Lavity Stoutt Community College, we believe that the educational experience we offer will not only enhance the lives of our graduates, but through them, organizations and communities as well. We believe that collectively, our graduates represent the rich tapestry of skills, attitudes, and personalities needed for any community to thrive. On today's program, you will learn of individuals who have continued their studies outside of the Virgin Islands and found the academic foundation laid by our institution to be a sound one. You will also learn of persons whose career growth has been positively impacted by their participation in our course offerings. We are proud of our graduates and pleased to give you a glimpse of the types of persons who have come through our doors. I'm Geraldine Ritter Freeman, Director of Communications, Public Relations and Marketing at HLSCC, as well as your host of today's program. You are watching Inside HLSCC. Stay tuned. We'll be back with more. BVI, dust off your running shoes and don't hesitate to participate in the upcoming HLSCC Race for a Cause, scheduled for Saturday, 24th November at the college's Parakita Bay campus. Registration is at 6:30 a.m. and the race begins at 7. All service clubs, schools, organizations, churches, and families are encouraged to participate in the HLSCC's Race for a Cause on Saturday, November 24th in support of the HLSCC Endowment Fund. Because an investment in HLSCC today is security, stability, and success for the BVI tomorrow. For more information about the Race for a Cause, including how to make a financial or other contributions, please call Race Director Stephanie Ross Penn at 852-7216. This final race is sponsored by Highland Springs and Rotown Wholesale. See you on the trail.
Celebrating the 18th annual performing arts season at HLSCC. The British Virgin Islands will be treated to the mesmerizing talent and grace of Ballet Next, the acclaimed independent dance company from New York City. Performing at the Aline L. Parsons Auditorium at 8 p.m. on November 17th. Ballet Next has forged an exciting creative laboratory, bringing together world-class choreographers, dancers, and musicians to develop contemporary work with the highest level of classical technique at its foundation. Known for being graceful, ballerinas inspire our inner selves to dance. And there's no better time than the beginning of our holiday season to let your heart soar. This creative dance showcase is a must-see. Secure your tickets today for Ballet Next, live at the Aline L. Parsons Auditorium on Saturday, November 17th at 8 p.m. Come and have a dance experience like never before. Sponsored by Lime and Friends of HLSCC.
Welcome back to Inside HLSCC. I'm Geraldine Ritter Freeman. Today on the program, I have the alumni of HLSCC who will be speaking to us about their experience at HLSCC. I'd like to introduce my guests, or at least allow them the opportunity to tell us who they are before we get into the interviewing section. We have with us Mr. Shane Xavier.
Yes, my name is Shane Xavier, and I am a past student of the HLSCC alumni.
And we'll certainly get more out of you, Shane, yes, today. Also, we have Ms. Florence Phillips, who is no stranger to us. But I just learned today that she's also an alumni of the HLSCC community. And Ms. Phillips, just tell us a little bit about your experience in terms of, you mentioned that you came through the doors more than once.
Yes, I did. Certainly did. Actually, my first experience was in 1999. Graduated in 2004, and then I went back again and graduated in 2007, and then last year, 2011.
Wow. We have to learn exactly what happened over those years, and now you're actually working. You're working at the college.
Yes, I am. I have been working.
You have been working as you were studying.
Yes.
Wonderful. That is excellent. And also, we have someone else who's working at the college, but also had an HLSCC experience as a student. Mr. Georges, welcome to the program as well.
Thank you. Thank you. Richard George's class of 2000 HLSCC, and I've been working there as a lecturer since 2004.
Okay, excellent. I am so happy to have you all on the program. As you know, one of our aims at the college is to bring more awareness as well as education. And one good way to do that, we thought, was to bring back some past students of the institution to speak about their experience. And hopefully in doing so, we can not only encourage others to consider HLSCC in the future, but we could also encourage our stakeholders to invest in the institution as well, and for others to support us in any way that they can. And so we want to just start the discussion. We learned a little bit about how each of you became acquainted with the institution. Tell us a little bit, let's go back to you, Mr. Xavier. Tell us a little bit about your experience. You were there for 2 years?
I was actually there for 2 years. I started in 2007 after I graduated from the BVA High School. Mm-hmm. And I started, I believe, in August 2007 and finished in June 2009.
Okay. And how was it? How do you recall your experience being at the college?
Well, it was interesting because usually in high school, you would have teachers behind your backs. They know your parents. So usually, if you weren't doing what you were supposed to do, they would always call them up and make sure that you get things done. Whereas in a college, it was more independent. And if you didn't do your work, you just didn't do your work. The teachers wouldn't be behind you or your parents trying to help you to get things done.
Okay, and how was that able to help you make that transition into the real world?
Well, in 2009, I graduated and I moved to the UK in England. Mm-hmm. So, of course, being so far away, teachers don't know your parents. And they usually have, you know, classrooms that are over 100, 200 people in them. So they really aren't that bothered about you like that. They're just there to teach the work, mark the papers, and go along with their life. So after my experience at HLSCC, I knew, okay, Shane, you came here to study, you need to do what you're supposed to do. Nobody is going to be behind you trying to help you to get things done, so you need to find the initiative and do things and do your work. Mm-hmm.
And can you attribute your success away all the way in the UK to your experience at HLSCC? Some of it at least.
Definitely. Mm-hmm. Because I remember after graduating from high school, they didn't really teach us the concept of referencing, for example. And going away to England, I realized that referencing was very important because you can actually be fined or sent to court if you don't reference properly. Mm-hmm. So I think HLSCC gave me a foundation when it came to referencing and doing the proper bibliography when I finished an essay or a research paper.
Okay. Any other specifics that you can talk to in terms of your experience at HLSCC as a student coming from, you're just spending that 2 years and you did receive your associate's degree from HLSCC. In terms of academic wise, were you able to maybe transfer credits? How did that work?
Well, in the United Kingdom, it's not similar to the US where you can transfer credits. Mm-hmm. But since it's a British overseas territory, I guess they have a lot of students coming from those territories and they are familiar with the schools. Okay. So once you have an associate degree, they would usually just take you onto the courses, whereas if you did not have it, they would make you do a foundation course. So doing the degree helped me to skip the foundation course, go straight into the degree and finish in 3 years.
Okay, I imagine that may have helped you in terms of cost and expense as well.
Yeah, definitely.
Having spent 2 years, and then how many years did you spend abroad?
I spent 3 years.
3 years.
It could have been four.
Could have been four.
Yeah.
Excellent. So you've benefited
in
more than one way.
Definitely.
Excellent. I will now turn to Ms. Phillips. Ms. Phillips, you are what I believe we'd term a mature student. You mentioned that you had several opportunities of which you took advantage of. I'm quite interested in knowing what were some of the areas that you pursued and why?
Actually, I wanted to enhance my skills and sort of develop myself personally because I found I like challenging things. And for me to be challenging in itself, it made me more aware that I needed to do other things as well. So mm-hmm. I thought of taking the opportunity to study and further, you know, my interests. Mm-hmm. One of my interests actually was in business studies. Having worked in the business field, as a young girl, I must say, assisted my father in the business. I developed an interest in the business as well, so I studied business. And then along the way, I found that I had an attachment to people in some way. Providing customer service was my main key. And I also had a concern with human behavior. So I decided to study human services and a bit of supervisory management. And then I went into the business studies. And then I also went into social sciences. Wow. So that gave me some personal development in growth. And the rest is history.
Mm-hmm. How did you become aware of the program offerings at HLSCC, being a resident?
Actually, I was employed at the college, mm-hmm. and I took the opportunity at that time. I started in 1999. And having been exposed to different cultures before, I also wanted to find out more about other things. So I took the opportunity to study, the human services, and as I said, I had an interest in business. So I just decided to do it. I wanted to develop myself personally. And one key thing was that you were encouraged to pursue your studies, and I took the opportunity again on that notice.
Okay, and tell me a little mm-hmm. bit about how you were able to manage your time working and still studying.
Time management. I always plan. I would set aside, I have to do this for this time, that for that time. I was always a very organized person to say. So I think the key point there is management, time management. And I think that's why I persevered.
Okay, great. Mm-hmm. Well, we're certainly going to hear more from you in terms of how you were able to be a success. And now you're working at the institution helping other students.
Yes.
We'll get back to that.
Okay.
Mr. Georges, you as well had your own experience with HLSCC as a student mm-hmm. and now as a lecturer. Tell us a little bit about what you're experiencing.
Well, I finished high school in 98. And I showed up at the Parakita Bay campus mm-hmm. at 7:30, 8 o'clock in the morning with my mom for the first day, for registration and whatnot. Mm-hmm. And I had my mind set that I was going to, having studied sciences at the high school, that I was going to be a computer science major. And within an hour or so, I was English major with a minor in government and politics.
Okay.
In 98. Now, so I think right away from day one, the college was a place where I started to figure out myself mm-hmm. as a 15-year-old boy and figure out what it was I wanted to do and what it was I was most passionate about. And over the 2 years I was there, I think what really developed in me was a understanding and appreciation of the benefits of hard work mm-hmm. and of putting yourself through some sort of rigorous procedure, mm-hmm. and the sense of accomplishment you feel when you've completed that. Mm-hmm. And when I finished my associate degree and I had done the Cambridge A-level exams and whatnot, I definitely had that feeling of accomplishment. And that was largely in part, due to the efforts of people like Sawada Smith and Dr. Almeen O'Neill and current president Dr. Carl Dawson, etc., who were all either my teachers or advisors. Mm-hmm. And so I really credit the college with that, helping me find, who it was I wanted to be and what it was I wanted to do. I spent the year 2000, 2001, actually, working at the college, both as a teaching assistant for the English department and as an assistant graphic designer in the then desktop publishing department. At the conclusion of that year, I transferred to Texas Christian University, where I went to finish my undergraduate degree mm-hmm. in English mm-hmm. and a minor in studio art.
And how was that transition, if you recall?
Mm-hmm. Well, I deliberately wanted to seek out a different experience, which is why I didn't go anywhere on the East Coast. I felt I had too much family and too much ease of connection. I felt like in order to grow, I wanted to put myself in a in an environment that was going to be different and challenging. And I think when I got to university, those values, you know, appreciation for academic rigor in particular is what was able to sustain me throughout the years in at TCU.
So in some way you felt HLSCC gave you a foundation?
Definitely, definitely. I had, like I said, I had some superb instructors. Not all of whom aren't still in the classroom, but I had some really, really good instructors, both in the English program and the then government and politics courses, which are taught by the late Stanley Gordon and current president, Dr. Carl Dawson.
Okay.
Yeah, so I had excellent instruction at the college from 98 to 2000, and that really, and I guess having experience of going to school in both the US and the UK, I can give some sort of comparison to the quality of instruction. And being a teacher myself now, I can really say that the teaching that I received, you know, as a teenager at HLSCC was, you know, top notch.
Second to none. Mm-hmm. Okay. That's my words now, putting in there. But I really appreciate that. But you're also a lecturer now at the college.
Mm-hmm.
And give me your perspective, having gone through some time as a student, mm-hmm. gone off, and then returning as a lecturer and having now to pass on your own skills and knowledge to current students. How is that for you?
Well, I never severed the umbilical cord, if you will, because after, you know, I was a student, then I was an employee, then I was abroad for 3 years. But even those 3 years, I would come back and I would work at the college part-time in the summers, you know, whether with the IT department or the desktop publishing department or whatever. And, you know, so as soon as I finished my degree, I came back to teach. And so I've always been, you know, attached to the college. And I've seen, you know, generations come, generations of students come and go. And, you know, I think the satisfaction that I get as a teacher now, seeing my past students, like I have one here to my left,
okay.
and a fellow student to my immediate left.
Wow.
So
okay.
when you see, you know, students come back and help to continue to build the country and the nation, it's a great sense of pride knowing that you played some role in their development, you know, and you can see the effects of their returning now.
Okay. You know? Well, that's very exciting. I didn't realize that my other two guests were your students. It just happened that
way. Well, she's a fellow student.
Fellow student.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. All right. Okay. Good. Excellent. One of the things I want to ask, though, for those persons who may not have had the privilege of attending the institution in any capacity, what would you say to them, and I'll ask each of you this question, what would you say to persons that is most valuable, not just for you, but for the Virgin Islands on a whole? What would you say is the most valuable thing about your experience with HLSCC to someone who may not have had such an experience?
I think the most valuable thing about HLSCC is what you get out of it, which is the education. Not everybody is able to go away and spend all those, you know, tons of money just to study at those big universities. So I feel that it presents an opportunity for people who are not financially stable because, as you know, if you're a BVLender, you can always go and study there for free.
Mm.
And, you know, even though we're not fully accredited as yet, I feel as though we have a top-notch college right here. So I believe that if you come and you study and you do the work, you will actually gain a lot of knowledge. You will actually improve upon the skills that you have and you'll become a better person from the school.
Wonderful. That is excellent. Well said. Ms. Phillips?
Yes, I have to speak from a mature point of view because I've heard the cry several times where, oh, I'm too old to start, or, you know, there's nothing that I can do because of my age, and that's not so because I started there 26 years after graduating from high school. Mm. So that will give you an idea. And I was actually practically the oldest student in almost every class.
Mm-hmm.
I was intimidated at first, but afterwards I became comfortable because, you know, I was going along with everybody else and actually did extremely well. And I think it's the perseverance. Don't mind the age. The college has several opportunities for all ages, and I would encourage anyone who's interested or just wants to enhance their skills or do something to make them better, that HLSCC is the way to go.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned the intimidation.
Yes.
And some persons who may have left school for many years may feel going back to the maths and English, that's really not what they would want at that stage in their life.
But
my understanding is that there's several other courses of which persons can be a part of, and they can get certified in specific areas.
Of course. Mm-hmm. There are also seminars and workshops mm-hmm. in community education. And some people just don't want to do a long program. They want to do a short course, or they just want to do one course or two courses. And HLSCC encourages that. Mm-hmm. So I would encourage anyone. Some people think, you have to have a college degree, or you can only come in there under certain criteria. There is an open door access, and I would encourage anyone who's interested in enhancing or their skills or want to develop themselves, or grow, that HLSCC has that opportunity for you.
Wonderful. Yes. Mm-hmm. Mr. Georges, what do you value the most about HLSCC as an institution, and when you think about the bigger picture in the Virgin Islands and our development?
I think what the college has been able to do for the nation is create access where there wasn't before. So much like Shane was saying earlier, you have now this incredible opportunity mm-hmm. where you have access to tertiary education at, a price you can't beat with a stick, as my father would say. And if you consider that, even though the college is going through the accreditation process, I just like to make a note that I've been teaching and advising now for 8 years at the college. And as a student myself, I took 60 credits to graduate with my associate's degree, and TCU took 56 of 60 credits. Mm-hmm. So credits transfer. So I just want to dispel any notions that your credits won't transfer if you're going to school in the US or the UK. So it's like Shane said, he got credit for his degree. They didn't have comparable courses to port over. Okay. But he got credit for the foundation courses. In the U.S. or Canada, once you are, getting A's and B's, mm-hmm. those will transfer. Mm-hmm. Granted, these are credit courses, not pass-fail courses. Mm-hmm. So I've had students transfer to Ivy League schools, and schools all across the U.S. and Canada and the U.K. Because of the access that HLSCC provided them. Mm-hmm. Now, I think it's important to note that Florence didn't say, but she is a member of the Honor Society at the college. I think she's being modest. That Honor Society provided a number of graduates with access to scholarships.
Exactly.
Not grants, not bonds, not government scholarships, but scholarships from the institution that they attended when they transferred.
And I can attest to that.
I know you can attest to that because your daughter is one of my advisees.
Yes. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Right? So, you're talking about people being able now to attend schools, abroad mm-hmm. that they might not have been able to afford otherwise. Mm-hmm. So the HLSCC is a doorway, or can be a doorway to the rest of your educational journey. So you get your associate's degree, but that might equal, a bachelor's degree that you, if you do well enough at HLSCC, that you might get, a scholarship to complete. I had an advisee who did his associate degree at HLSCC. He was a member of the Honor Society. He got a full ride scholarship to Embry-Riddle. Mm-hmm. He completed his degree in aeronautical engineering, mm-hmm. and they asked him back to do his master's, and they paid for it.
Mm-hmm.
I have several of these, examples that I can spout off. I think so. That's one thing that HLSCC has really been able to do that I don't think any other avenue, that exists in the BVI can, in terms of creating the access and opportunity to complete higher degrees.
Okay, mm-hmm. I want to turn a little bit from academics because mm-hmm. we only have a little bit of time in the program, but what about your overall experience at the college? Were you able to participate in any other activities, the clubs that they have, the different events? What about the performing arts series? You have races, all sorts of things are going on at the college besides classes. What was your experience like, Shane? Were you able to have fun?
Honestly, I'll be honest about this. The only thing I really did at the college was study.
Okay.
But I do regret not joining groups and going to the performing arts, because I feel like when you take part in those activities, you feel more, more like attached to the school in a sense. Okay. Like you feel like it's home. Okay. So,
I would encourage. If you had it to do it all over again, you would have participated more.
Yeah.
In the activities.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. What about you, Ms. Phillips? Were you able to participate in any cheerleading or anything?
I feel the same. Like Shane, I actually was more focused on getting good grades.
Okay.
So I spent a lot of time focusing on that. But if I had to do it all over again, I would be interested in drama, because I love drama. Okay. I actually was in a drama club at a younger age, and I would engage in that.
Is it a very competitive environment that people are so focused on their work?
Actually, I see there's a lot of competition. Everybody seems to be more focused now on getting the highest GPA and all of that. So there's a competition going on, for sure.
Okay, high standards up at the college.
Yes.
What about you? Did you participate in any clubs?
Well, I was a member of the social club in 1998, and I think it's now defunct.
Okay.
But now there are several.
But what
other,
was the social club?
Was that?
What was the social
club?
We
used to have events on campus. We used to organize like games against faculty and students. We used to have fashion shows and movie nights, and it was before the auditorium was commissioned and whatnot.
Okay.
So. It was a way for us to, again, to feel attached to the institution.
Okay.
You know, so we used to do little things like that to try and enhance the community of the college. But now we have several clubs and organizations on campus, of which I am an advisor for a few. Mm-hmm. And of course, other members of faculty play advisory roles. There's, you know, debate clubs, and there's drama societies, which Florence should join.
Mm-hmm, for sure.
There's the Honor Society. A few years ago, a couple lecturers and myself started the football on Friday afternoons.
Okay.
And also, there's lots of things. You see, as the institution grows, you know, as the years go by, you see more and more of these activities, extracurricular activities, popping up and starting to last a little longer than they used to when the school was a bit smaller.
Okay. Well, finally, I'm going to ask you to just say something to the alumni of the institution in terms of how do they continue to be a part of the institution, as well as other stakeholders and supporters who may want to be a part of the institution but not quite sure how they can still be a part of the institution, whether by making contributions financially or otherwise. Shane, are you still actively involved with with HLSCC?
Well, I'm here now. So
okay.
That's one example, but I would just say you could either contribute through funds or simply by word of mouth encourage people to come to the college, especially like if you have children, you should be encouraging them, if you are a past student, to go and pursue an education as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
I would encourage everyone from the youngest to the oldest, because I'm going to be honest, we've had students who are actually 71 years up that attended HLSCC, so it's never too late to attend. I'm encouraging those who think it's too late. It's not too late. Just come to HLSCC. You can give us a call to find out what your interest, you know, if you have an interest, and we can let you know. We'll guide you to the right path, and you'll be surprised. You know, you're a better person afterwards. I feel better. Mr. George has actually taught me a few things as well, I'm going to be honest, you know, as a mature student, and I admire him for that, and I also admire students who persevere, because at HLSCC we have faculty and staff who cares, but you have to show the initiative, and that's important as well. So once you come to HLSC and you have the initiative and you want to persevere, we are all willing to help, because we are a college family.
Excellent.
Yes.
And what are your thoughts to persons who may be considering coming to HLSCC as students, as well as persons who have already left the institution? How can they still be a part of the institution?
I'll talk first to alumni.
Okay.
And I think the most important thing alumni can do is to be witnesses and to share their experiences, because most of the people who have passed through the college, you know, and who have graduated and who have transferred on, who have continued their journey, you know, the college was a formative, or played a formative role in that journey. Mm-hmm. And I'm not going to say everybody, but most. Mm-hmm. You know, I think too often we don't speak up, you know, and I think, the college's reputation, the college's perception, you know, is one that can only be enhanced if the people who have been there, like myself, continue to talk about our experiences and talk about the quality of education that we received at the college, you know, and how it prepared us for the next phase in our lives. That's the first thing I would say for alumni, you know, tell somebody, okay, you know, mm-hmm, about your experience. In terms of people who are considering, you know, attending or contributing, I think Florence spoke very well about, you know, the benefits of coming, regardless of the stage of life that you're in. In terms of other stakeholders or shareholders in the community, I think being involved, you know, we have the performing arts series, you know, that, you know, you can be involved financially or you can be involved in terms of time, you know, showing up, partaking with the in the college classic series, the races. And there are a number of student groups on campus, you know, that could benefit from, mm-hmm, you know, guidance, from advice, from, you know, pep talks from people in the community who have expertise in the areas. For example, there's an environmental club, there's a hospitality club. You know, these are all avenues or opportunities for people in the community to create connections with the college and with the students. If these are people who are ultimately going to eventually become your employees or your future managers of industry. Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much, Mr. Georges. And as you mentioned, the performing arts series, as well as the race series, I think now is a good time to invite the general public to participate in the upcoming concert, which will be Ballet Next, which will be held on 17 November, Saturday. And we want everyone in the community to come out and enjoy that performance. That's a ballet company out of New York, and they're excellent. You can look them up on the internet and learn more about that company, and certainly come out and support the next concert. Again, that is on the 17th of November. And also the HLSCC's annual Race for a Cause will be held on 24th November. And that is an annual race that the HLSCC puts on to raise awareness to specific causes in a community. And this year, the beneficiary will be HLSCC. The proceeds will go towards HLSCC's endowment fund. We encourage you to come out again, Race for a Cause. That's 6:30 a.m. registration, 7 a.m. the race will begin. Race for a Cause, you can come to participate in a race or you can come and make a contribution. We'll be back to close off the program after this word.
Celebrating the 18th annual performing arts season at HLSCC, the British Virgin Islands will be treated to the mesmerizing talent and grace of Ballet Next, the acclaimed independent dance company from New York City. Performing at the Aline L. Parsons Auditorium at 8 p.m. on November 17th, Ballet Next has forged an exciting creative laboratory, bringing together world-class choreographers, dancers, and musicians to develop contemporary work with the highest level of classical technique at its foundation. Known for being graceful, ballerinas inspire our inner selves to dance, and there's no better time than the beginning of our holiday season to let your heart soar. This creative dance showcase is a must-see. Secure your tickets today for Ballet Next, live at the Aline L. Parsons Auditorium on Saturday, November 17th at 8 p.m. Come and have a dance experience like never before. Sponsored by Lime and Friends of HLSCC.
BVI, dust off your running shoes and don't hesitate to participate in the upcoming HLSCC Race for a Cause, scheduled for Saturday, 24th November at the college's Parakita Bay campus. Registration is at 6:30 a.m. and the race begins at 7. All service clubs, schools, organizations, churches, and families are encouraged to participate in the HLSCC's Race for a Cause on Saturday, November 24th, in support of the HLSCC Endowment Fund. Because an investment in HLSCC today is security, stability, and success for the BVI tomorrow. For more information about the Race for a Cause, including how to make a financial or other contributions, please call Race Director Stephanie Ross Penn at 852-7216. This final race is sponsored by Highland Springs and Rotown Wholesale. See you on the trail. I want to thank my guests for being a part of today's program. I really appreciate you taking the time out of your schedule to come and to make your contribution in this way by speaking about HLSCC, and be sure to come back again soon.
Pleasure.
Thank you.
You've been watching Inside HLSCC, a new television program aimed at heightening awareness about the college, building community relations, and contributing to the overall development of these Virgin Islands. On the program today, we had alumni of the institution speaking about their own experiences at HLSCC and beyond. In summary, I leave you with this quote from American journalist Tom Brokaw. You are educated. Your certification is in your degree. You may think of it as the ticket to the good life. Let me ask you to think of an alternative. Think of it as your ticket to change the world. I'm Geraldine Ritter Freeman, Director of Communications, Marketing, and Public Relations at HLSCC. Until next time, remember, an investment in HLSCC today is stability, security, and success for the BVI tomorrow. Thank you.